I just broke the train by using a toilet.
Перешитая компанию вам запрещено снимать жену с этого уголовного дела, то что вы покушаетесь на компанию.
Agent Nesty at your service. In this video, I want to invite you to go on a Russian train trip with me. These trips, they have their own unique vibe, and I want to try to share this vibe with you. And let's hurry up, because if I will not hurry up, we will not have any video today because I'm so late. Missing a train or plane is one of my nightmares.
Yes, I only paid 40 bucks to drive more than 1,000 kilometers.
But it was my 40 bucks. So we are going to make the most of this trip.
Я пытаюсь.
Сюда
тоже?
We just started going, and the first thing which we start when the train is going is of course eating. Let me show you that I took with myself to eat for 2 days, and what Russians usually take with themselves to eat in the train. I don't even know why I took so much pepper, I don't know.
I also took 2 sandwiches, but now moving to classics.
3 boiled eggs, chicken. And of course, this, we call it bepeshka, dasharak, beach packet. Like, it has a lot of names, but it is always with you when you're on a train in Russia. This is like mashed potato. This is spaghetti.
Wow.
Spaghetti.
When I was a kid traveling with my parents, it was the best part of the whole trip, eating this. And last but not least, of course, I took a lot of tea bags, just a lot, and you will understand why.
The train in which we are traveling today is called Platzkart. It is also called third class, but we don't really call it third class. This is the cheapest train. There are also more expensive compartments. It is second class and first class, and also VIP. I don't even know how they look like. When I was a kid, we, my parents, we always choose Platzkart, and most of the people do this in Russia. And it's not only because it is the cheapest, but also because of that, but it's not only one reason. It is also because then you're traveling alone, it's kind of make more sense than you are not close to 4 strangers in one room. It's not like it's not safe, but I just feel more comfortable being locked with 52 more people. This is how many people in here right now.
Yeah, these two is the most comfortable places because you have a table, there is also you can charge your phone, and it's pretty comfortable in there and quite a lot of space. To get in here you need to climb while using this stair, and it's not really comfortable because to eat you need to go downstairs and there is another person sleeping, so it's not really comfortable. But if you're a child, of course choose this one because it's so much fun.
I think this place is the most uncomfortable one because to get the table you need to undo the bed, and to make the bed you need to undo the table, and it's even more uncomfortable if you're in there. To get the table to eat you need to ask a person to make the table so you can eat. Uncomfortable.
No one asked, of course, as usual, but I decided that you need to see the toilet on the Russian train. So let's go there with a professional camera. I walk past people, I go to the toilet with a camera. Let me know how you like this toilet.
This is so embarrassing.
You can use charger in here. Welcome to the toilet, and this is terrifying. It is shaking in here, so there is really big possibility people will miss. Jesus Christ! Big possibility people will miss their target. Here is the soap. Like, in theory, here is usually soap and here is water. It is cold, but you can make it warm. But here is one thing that terrifies me no matter how old I am. Like, for example, you finished all what you needed to do and you use this button. Why is this sound is so scary? Like, the toilet is gonna blow up. Also, then poised is going and going really fast and it's all moving and it really feels like I just broke the train by using a toilet. The most interesting is what kind of neighbors you will meet. Your entire trip vibe will depend on this. For some reason, I always get cute babushka and we talk about life and they feed me sweets. And at 11 p.m. the train falls asleep.
Good morning. It's time for breakfast because what else to do in the train? My neighbor is sleeping, so I'm trying to be quieter. But I want to show you how to eat this. I don't know, have you ever tried it? And I already prepared some tea. This is the signature cup. I love it so much. I don't know why. It just looks so cozy and stylish. They have these cups on every train. And you can see here their logo. It's like Russian railway. Railway.
There is a boiler and you need to be very careful while using this because it's always so hot, like it boils water without stops. Usually Russians are making noodles, but I love mashed potato not less and I just broke everything. I put water inside and now I'm supposed to close it, so the magic works, but not in my case. I tried to eat sandwich which I got yesterday and it tastes weird. It's kind of hot in here, you know, it's not really cold. Here is an air conditioner, but it's working only when you're going, so maybe technically it's not air conditioner but just the wind from outside. I'm not sure about that information. So I guess this sandwich is dead and another sandwich is dead and chicken for sure already dead, maybe eggs also. At least I have some vegetables. But if you did not took any food with you, that's okay because you can buy it from conductor or also here is people walking here and there. I'm guessing there are workers of the train as well and they are offering pies. And also here is a dining car. I don't know how to call it, like the whole restaurant in the train. It's quite expensive always, so I usually don't go there. I don't know, maybe I will go with you just to show, but I'm quite anxious. I never did this. But if you're rich, you can do this. And also, if you're rich, you can support my channel. But only if you're rich. If you want, you can join my community on Patreon or Boosty. We have a secret chat there in Telegram. There I can talk freely. And also, I post their videos first before uploading them on YouTube. But if you will just like and follow my channel, it will be already huge support. Thank you.
Okay, let's go to this dining car. I just learned that this restaurant is always in the middle of the train. To get in there, I just need to go that direction for about 12 cars. Let's go. This is still not a restaurant. Why? I'm already so stressed.
РЖД компанию вам запрещено снимать только с их разрешения, иначе вам выставят штрафы.
Хорошо, спасибо.
И что оно до этого, как говорится, доводится, как говорится, даже может до уголовного дела. То, что вы покушаетесь на компанию и то, что вы не согласовали.
Понятно. Буду знать. Хорошо, спасибо, что сказали. Я тогда лучше буду просто себя снимать.
Пожалуйста.
Спасибо.
Only commercial filming is banned in the train, and personal as fuck is allowed if you don't disturb anyone. The conductor at my place apparently knew that because she was very kind and curious what I filmed, but sometimes to smile and leave is better than to argue.
If the next one not gonna be a restaurant, I did it all for nothing. It was kind of stressful trip, so I decided I'm gonna order something. People here keep asking me like, am I blogger? Are you blogger? And there's always different reactions. Worker just passed by me and she smiled and just waved me.
So I gave my YouTube link to waiter, ordered coffee and tried very hard to drink it. And on the way back I was already not afraid of anything. I have grown as a person on this short journey. And while I'm showing you, for some reason, woman selling fish, let me tell you main reasons why Russians like trains more than planes.
First one, it is so convenient. The passenger railway in Russia connects a lot of cities. And the train always arrives directly into the city, while airports usually are far away from the city. Second one is security. Because train, it is going on the earth. It doesn't fly, so it doesn't fall. This is my personal favorite. Third one is, of course, the price, because especially for long Russian distances, train is much more cheaper than any plane ticket. And fourth is, of course, comfort. I personally always feel myself like a Hogwarts student while I'm traveling on the train, especially at winter and autumn time. I always sleep like that woman in the trains. I can sleep for like 10 or 15 hours. So if you will come to Russia anytime, just make sure you will have this experience.
During the rest of my trip, I went out for a walk at long stop Bogh Ryazhenka and was just chilling, reading. I think that's all I wanted to show you, and I'm already so tired of editing this video, so as usual, any questions is welcome in the comments, and like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching my video to the end. Go watch our ones. And take care of yourself. Пока-пока.